South Korean tech giant Samsung reportedly cutting up to 30% of its overseas staff. Sources told Reuters Samsung has instructed its subsidiaries worldwide to reduce sales and marketing staff by 15% and administrative staff by up to 30%. That plan is expected to be implemented by the end of this year. In a statement, Samsung said workforce adjustments at some overseas operations were routine and aimed at improving efficiency. It added that there were no specific targets for the plans. America's presidential contenders Kamala Harris and Donald Trump battle over the economy in their first presidential debate. Democratic bet Harris slammed Trump for planning to increase trade duties and allegedly selling American chips to Beijing for military purposes. She also cited the unemployment rate during his term, which had peaked at 14.8% back in April 2020.
Let's talk about what Donald Trump left us. Donald Trump left us the worst unemployment since the Great Depression. Donald Trump left us the worst public health epidemic in a century. Donald Trump left us the worst attack on our democracy since the Civil War. And what we have done is clean up Donald Trump's mess.
Trump, for his part, criticized Harris for persistent inflation under the Biden administration. He called the state of the economy a disaster for people across all socioeconomic classes.
Look, we've had a terrible economy because inflation has, which is really known as a country buster, it breaks up countries. We have inflation like very few people have ever seen before, probably the worst in our nation's history.
Let's check on European markets. They are up in afternoon trade as investors pick up gains ahead of the European Central Bank's policy decision on Thursday. The German DAX is up nearly 0.5%, while the French CAC 40 is higher by 0.33%. The London FTSE 100, though, is seeing smaller gains after data showed the British economy flatlined for a second straight month in July, missing the 0.2% forecast. As for Wall Street, futures are down ahead of the August CPI report, which is expected to show U.S. headline inflation eased 2.6% in August. That report will be followed by Thursday's producer price index, with both data seen to help determine the size of the expected rate cut from the Fed on September 18. Some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Trump Media following the former president's debate against Kamala Harris. Analysts have said Harris had bested Trump in that face-off. Trump Media shares sank 14% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Commerzbank after Italy's UniCredit acquired a 9% stake in the Germany-based lender. Now, this sent the stock soaring 18%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Rent-to-Kill after the pest control company warned of a sharp slowdown in its largest market, North America. Rent-to-Kill shares plunged 19%. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade lower as investors braced for the U.S. inflation report. Japan's Nikkei 225 also weighed by strong yen, which hit an eight-month high after a Bank of Japan official said policymakers will continue to raise interest rates if inflation moves in line with their forecast. Philippine shares joined the downswing, with the main index snapping a four-day win streak.
Defensive positioning is absolutely crucial in today's market. With a host of local market-moving catalysts and the latest earnings report from publicly listed firms all set to be unveiled this October, it's important to tread carefully. My recommendation is to stick with the sectors with stable earnings like utilities, consumer staples, and banks. However, don't forget to keep a watchful eye out on potential bargains. Sectors such as property and consumer discretionary might offer promising opportunities, especially once the dust settles in on the interest rate uncertainties.